you say, huh? Now what they say, huh? Now what they say, huh? And we're here on the Talk of the Town with two great friends of mine, Miss Jenny and Miss Rebecca. Guys, thanks for being on the show today. I really appreciate it.
Thanks for coming in. Thank you.
So it's around the holiday times, and what perfect place than to be at Over the Moon store? And can you guys tell them the exact location where they could come to come to this great store?
Sure. So Through the Moon Gate and Over the Moon Toys are at 440 Raritan Avenue at the corner of Raritan Avenue and Fifth Avenue. Yeah.
Perfect, perfect. So what... where did this idea to even start a great store like this come from? Because it just like brightens up the whole Raritan Ave, especially now that it's you know, around the holiday times. Where did this idea come from?
We started our gift shop Through the Moon Gate just out of sort of a dream to do our own thing. Mm-hmm. And our love for fair trade items, our items that are made by artists, supporting local art and that kind of thing. And then it just sort of grew into a toy store as we had children, and it just made sense. And the two go together. Yeah. You know, everybody wants a little bit of both. Definitely. So it works out perfectly.
Definitely.
Yeah.
And I see you guys have a couple items in front of us today.
Could
you explain some of these items that we have in front of us today?
So we've got both sides represented here. So Through the Moon Gate likes to focus on fair trade items like the linens, mm-hmm, and the ornaments. And we also like to focus on American-made artists and products, like our candles from the Times and this hand-blown glass ornament. And then we have local pieces here, too. This is a pottery made by Brian Whites, who's from Highland Park.
Oh.
And we have capsaicin made by David Bell, who also lives here in Highland Park. He grows his own peppers, smokes them, and makes these wonderful, delectable things to eat. I highly recommend it. And then on the toy store side, we like to do the same thing. We like to show fair trade, American made, and local locally designed items. So this doll here is made by a woman from Metuchen.
Oh, wow.
The watches are designed by two gentlemen in New Brunswick.
Watch too.
Compounded All is made by the Adlermans, and who also live in Metuchen, and they're also local authors and illustrators and musicians.
Compounded All.
Yeah, it's a wonderful game. Pengolu is made by a company that features products that are sustainably harvested, wooden items and things like that. They're a wonderful game company. And they also make Spot It. And here we're showing Shalom Spot It, one of the new Spot It games from Blue Orange.
Oh, wow.
And then our truck here is made in Vermont by, I mean, it looks, when you go in, it looks like Santa's workshop. It's just a wood shop, and they make these beautifully crafted items. So I'd like to show a little of everything here.
That's perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect. So besides the toys, you know, what's your favorite part about the store?
I think it would have to be about the people in town.
Yeah.
I think that's my favorite. I think seeing the kids come in, thoroughly enjoying themselves. For that matter, the adults that come in and get silly, that's got to be my favorite.
Yeah. But that was a nice side effect of opening up a shop here. We opened up a shop to do business here and be our own bosses. And then the being part of the community in a way we didn't expect was just a wonderful side effect of all of it. So,
yeah.
So as you guys can see at home, that we're wearing these pins and they say shop small on it. Can you guys explain what shop small is for the viewers at home that might not have heard about it, because this is new to me as well, but I think it's such an amazing thing.
So Small Business Saturday is the first Saturday after Thanksgiving. It happens every year now. We can thank American Express for starting this. It's sort of the small business's answer to Black Friday.
Mm-hmm.
So they give incentives for people who use their American Express, and small businesses like ours give incentives to our customers for coming in and thanking them for coming in and shopping small. And one of the things that our viewers should know is that when you shop small, when you shop in local brick-and-mortar businesses, you get 63% of your sale back into your community. In payroll, in the local hires, you know, that when we hire people, and when we purchase our own stuff in town. So that just goes right back, and sales tax and so on, goes right back into the community. So it's a wonderful thing all around, and you only get that by shopping small.
Make sure you shop small.
Yes.
Also, I did my homework on you, lady.
Oh, no.
And so I just wanted to commend you on on the television show about, I heard about what you guys do around the holiday times, and you guys give back toys, you know, to the less fortunate. I think that's such a beautiful thing. And,
we believe definitely. In Santa Claus.
Oh,
we do. So we
Santa is real.
Yeah. We're Santa's helpers, mm-hmm. and everybody that celebrates Christmas should have something under the tree, and not just clothing. And that's a wonderful. The schools and the churches in the area give back also by by supplying clothing gifts to kids that need it. But we also think kids need to play. It's an important part of growing.
Definitely.
And learning. So we give back toys.
Definitely. So any final words to the viewers at home?
Well, we hope that you'll visit Through the Moon Gate and Over the Moon Toys and all of the other wonderful businesses here in Highland Park.
Definitely. Any last words?
I'm fine with that. That sounds good to me.
Happy holidays from over
here. Happy holidays!
Thank you guys. We'll be back.
Did you know about 40% of high school graduates don't attend college each year? Due to financial restraints. So that's why I decided to start the Hometown Hero Club, where 25% of each purchase will go towards a scholarship fund and be awarded at the end of each year to the next Hometown Hero.
And we're back here on the Talk of the Town. I'm your host, Ashton Burrell. And right now we're sitting here at the Bank of Wood Bridge with the branch manager, Miss Stephanie Kim. Thanks for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
Well, thank you for having us here at your beautiful bank. First off, let's start off, what do you do here?
Well, I'm the branch manager here for Bank of Wood Bridge, a division of BCB Community Bank. From our day-to-day, I oversee the entire branch here for our operations, our sales, or so. We are based in Bayonne. The BCB stands for Bayonne Community Bank. So once we started to branch into Woodbridge, we named it Bank of Woodbridge, a division of BCB Community Bank, and that's what we kind of model in our other towns. You know, if we go to Monroe, it's BCB Monroe. And also in our other, local towns in Fairfield or so, it's BCB Fairfield. We are a $1.5 billion community bank based in New Jersey. We're a thriving community bank that, prides ourselves on hard work, all the local conveniences of community banking. We're celebrating our 15th year anniversary this year.
Congratulations.
Thank you. And we believe in investing in the communities that we serve.
That's amazing. And speaking of investing in the communities that you serve, I love the setup when we came in. The holiday stuff, you got the candy canes, you got the Kwanzaa, you got the menorah, you got everything going. Around the holiday times, people start blowing money. Crazy. What are some things that people could do to save around the holiday times?
Well, for me, I came up with the top three in my head.
Okay.
One thing that I actually do myself is if you have a credit card that you use all year, so most credit cards offer a rewards points program. I redeem those points during the holidays for gift cards. And that's one way where I don't have to spend that money for gift cards to give to my family members and Secret Santa or so here at the branch, and it's easy.
Well, I like them all, so I take one of those gift cards for them.
All right, definitely. And next thing I have, really, you have to keep track of your spending.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, your budget, it really does you no good if you don't effectively track your spending.
Mm-hmm.
I personally keep a separate Christmas fund. It's actually just dedicated, the Christmas fund is dedicated in for my bank account. It's actually separate.
Oh, wow.
It makes it easier for me to separate holiday spending from regular day-to-day expenses. Yeah, and then if you check with your local bank, a lot of them have like a Christmas club, or you can just open a separate savings account just for the holidays or vacation also with that time coming around. And another thing I have is just choose less expensive traditions. Traditions are what makes the holidays so special, but they can become a financial burden. If your traditions include like holiday travel or a special attraction or so, then you might find yourself going significantly over budget. So some of the things I would say is, you know, you can take a day and just tour in the neighborhood with the Christmas lights and then just the local area. And then see a high school production at or show, a choir show at the high school instead of going over to the city. Now you have all of that expenses going over to the city and tolls and everything. That's how you know it. And then just checking daily deals on Groupon or Living Social. It's discounts on local attractions that you can just do in the area.
Definitely. Those are some smart things I'm definitely going to keep in mind for the holidays.
Furthermore, it teaches just the little ones that traditions aren't about what you spend, but the time you spend together.
Oh, I like that message. It's yes, not about definitely. The gifts, kids. So that's some great ways for the holidays. Now, besides people wanting to get in the gym when the new year comes, mm-hmm. I know they're also thinking of ways for the new year. So what's some tips on saving for the new year's?
Well, I know a lot of people go in 2016, my year to save more money. I even have some clients that will come in, they want to start open a new account just for the new year to save money. But before you can even start with that, you need to unload on some of the debt that you have. I'm sure some people have picked up debt over the holidays. And it's hard to save when you're weighed down by high interest rate credit card debt. That's why paying off the debt should be your top priority for the new year. So start with the accounts that have the highest interest rate on your credit card and work your way down from that. And then also just talk with your partner about your finances and how you guys can work together with each other with paying off your debt and any other future plans that you might have with your finances, and just staying focused on the goal that, you know, you have a goal, you want to save, you know, additional $5,000 more than you did the previous year. People tend to be most excited about their goals and spending plans early in the new year, but you can keep the motivation going by writing your own goals and even creating a visual representation of them. So if you want to travel to Australia, for example, just keep photos of your potential dream vacation handy so you can pull them out when you're tempted to spend money on something you really don't need.
Definitely.
So that's kind of what I try to do. But yeah. Normally, I still spend it on something I don't need.
Yeah. I noticed fast food is like one of my killers. It all adds up at the end.
Yes, yeah. It does.
So I gotta stop eating.
You have to, yeah, end of the month, do a spreadsheet with that.
Oh, man. So, holiday times, what's one of your favorite things about the holidays? What do you love about the holidays?
What I love about the holidays, well, my favorite part about the holiday season is, especially Christmas time, is it's a time to renew my connections with the people that are important to me. And many times I get to talk to my family that's in another country. They'll call just during the holidays where maybe I won't speak to them as much, during the year. And that's basically, and plus, you know, you exchange little gifts. It's time spent. Some people take off an entire week just to sit down and relax with the family.
That's so cute. Isn't that cute?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, perfect, perfect. Any favorite Christmas memories?
Favorite Christmas memories for me? I guess favorite Christmas memory was when I found out who actually want my Christmas gifts.
Oh, wow.
When I actually found out that year and I discovered them on my own.
Oh, okay. Perfect. So Santa didn't come that year.
Santa didn't come that year. For me.
So on that note, we want to say thank you for joining us today with Talk of the Town.
Thank you.
We hope we see you again. And we'll be looking for our $1 million check in the mail.
Yes, thank you. Come by.
We'll be back.
Did you know about 40% of high school graduates don't attend college each year due to financial restraints? So that's why I decided to start the Hometown Hero Club, where 25% of each purchase will go towards a scholarship fund and be awarded at the end of each year to the next Hometown Hero.
And now, welcome to Fashion 101 with your host, Rick Styles.
Rick Styles here, and this is Fashion 101 End of Year Edition. We're going to go over some fashion tips that you can leave in 2015. Number one, the display of your high-end belt. Leave it alone. You're going to tuck in your shirt just to show the emblem on your belt, or you're going to have your pants sagging halfway off your butt just so we can see the whole belt. It's done. Either it's official or it's bootleg, but we don't care. If we did, we would have had one by now. So leave it alone. That's done 2015. Number two, fellas wearing your 3X gym shorts under your jeans and under your khakis. Leave it alone. You at the basketball court playing in the full outfit with your gym gear under there. If you really want a ball, take that stuff off and play in your gym shorts. And the last one, a whole denim jean outfit. Leave it alone. Break it up. Either one, wear the coat or the jacket and the jeans separately. If anything, the denim shirt is always in style, but break up the whole denim outfit. You're never going out saying, you know what, I'm going to kill it when I put on this jean jacket and these jean pants. It just doesn't look right. But enjoy. Enjoy your holidays with your family and your friends. And that's Rick Styles signing out. Happy holidays.
Did you know about 40% of high school graduates don't attend college each year due to financial restraints? So that's why I decided to start the Hometown Hero Club, where 25% of each purchase will go towards a scholarship fund and be awarded at the end of each year to the next Hometown Hero.
So there we have it. Our normal fashion tips from Rick Styles on things that we could leave in 2015. We got a chance to talk with a great toy star, and I thank them for allowing us to come in there and check out all the great things. I hope you guys get a chance to drop by there. And we also got some great financial tips on ways to save around the holiday time and also for the New Year's. Now, one of my favorite things about the holiday time is my annual charity basketball game that I get to do with my mentorship program. I'm going to end the show with some highlights from the game, and you guys get to see me on the court do what I do best. But I want to end the show also saying, happy holidays, have a healthy new year, and I wish you all the best. Thanks for always supporting the Talk of the Town with Ashton Burrell. 2016 is going to be bigger and better. Once again, I'm your host, Ashton Burrell. Thanks for tuning in. We'll be right back.
Let us know.